Assalamualaikum, Tawul Lextrim, Madam Munira. Today our group will be presenting about is the weight of the pineapple related to the amount of juice it produces. In our today's presentation, we will divide it into four parts, which is the objectives, methodology, conclusion, and recommendation. The objectives will be explained by Farhan. Amirul Aiman will explain about methodology. Conclusion will be explained by Izham, and Zakon will explain about our project's recommendation. Okay, firstly, pineapples are well known to its various ways to use in our daily lives, and one of its ways is to produce juice. So, our group have been wondering, is the amount of juice is produced related to the pineapple's weight? So to know this result, we have made our own hypothesis, and we have done our own experiment and project to know about the amount of juice pineapples produce is related to the weight of the pineapples. Next, I will give Farhan will continue our presentation to explain about our group's objectives. Thank you.
So the firstly, the objective is to study the amount of the juice produced with the number of the pineapples cubed. Second, the objective is to predict the amount of juice produced and the weight of the pineapple and the weight of the pineapple itself. And we believe that if the weight is higher, the juice produced will be more. Lastly, the objective is about to measure the coefficient of linear correlation between the weight of the pineapples and the amount of juice itself. So this correlation can be get after we measure all the weight of the pineapples and the juice of it. So we will do a formula to find the correlation of it. So that's all for me. Thank you.
Thank you, Farhan. Now I will continue our presentation for the methodology part. We collect the data at my house, which is located at Camp Kementah, Kuala Lumpur. Then we assign the weight of the pineapple as the independent variable, while the total juice produced as the dependent variable. We measure the weight and the total of juice produced by using the electronic balance. Okay, after collect all the data, we calculate the coefficient of linear correlation by using this formula. Okay, that's all from me. Now I will let Izham to continue our presentation by talk about conclusion.
Thank you, Amirul Aiman, for the clear explanation of the methodology part. So, moving on to the next point, which is the conclusion. So, in conclusion, based on our data and findings, it can be concluded that the weight of pineapple use is actually directly proportional to the amount of juice it produces, which means that if the weight of pineapple use increase, the amount of juice it produces also increase. This statement can be proved based on our value of R, which is the coefficient of linear correlation, is 0.9997, which is almost close to positive 1, thus proving our data is actually very highly perfect positive correlation. Hence, if the weight of pineapple use increase, the amount of juice it produce also increase. So I'll pass the talk to Zakwan for the recommendation part.
So next, we will move to the recommendation. Actually, we want to produce more juice. Okay. After do the research, we find that to produce more juice pineapple, we must remove the pineapple ice. The pineapple's ice should be removed with a pineapple ice remover to minimize its content loss. So we will get more juice of pineapple. So I think that is all from us. I hope you enjoy with our presentation. Bye.